Merry Christmas and ho, ho, ho. And if I just offended you, well, I wasn't talking to you. And cue the fire, the only time of the year that I could call someone a ho and get away with it. Kind of like that random guy behind me that just walks around. Hey, hey, ho, hey, hey, simp, come back. And shout out to JoJo Flight Attendant, my daughter, she got to me Christmas clothing. My kids always say, Dad, it's just so hard to buy for you. I'm like, really? All I want is black. I'm like, make it big, black, warm, and make sure it comes with a zipper. You're good. But your spending is down this year. Your savings are gone. And cue the fire. You spent all your money. And now you're gonna have to go. Yeah, hello, little TV set. You're gonna have to go get a job, even though this guy back here, Warren Buffett, says, I have to look at it. If you don't find a way to make money when you're asleep, make sure you marry someone that makes a lot of money and then you can sleep like a charm. Which I think sleeping like a charm is just, it's better than a rock. Why do you want to sleep like a rock? That's not attractive. But he says, you will work until you die. And I say, thank you, Warren Buffett, but believe it or not, people, you will work until you die. So we're going to talk about that in this video. That is not very Christmas-like. Bravo, but people are like, I need money for Christmas. That's what everyone's asking for this Christmas. They're not asking for alcohol. Hello, I'll take it. They're asking for cold, hard cash. I mean, let's go, Brandon. Your spending is down. That's what right now I'm looking at the charts. Your savings are gone. I'm looking at them. People want cash for Christmas. Americans, they're an aging population. That's not good, and you guys don't want to have any kids except for my kids. So it looks like I'll be Papa Bravo in 2022. So it looks like Robin Hood Kid, also known as my daughter Kayla. We call her Bean. Looks like she's going to have a little baby Bean. But honestly, like, why bring a child into this? And I mean, what could possibly go wrong with 2022? Even though the word T-O-O, it's like we're repeating 2020 again, which might be a good thing. Because it turned out okay, right? We just have to have a Black Swan event. They'll just push you a lot of money. Everything is fixed. Well, except for that darn hyperinflation thing. I hate when that comes into play. As you can see here, money is running out. Financial stress drives retirees back to work. Gotta go get a job, Papa. But what I wanted to talk to you about was, I got a lot to talk to you about. I have problems and I have solutions. It's like vanilla ice. Yo, I'll solve it. Property taxes. And honestly, I don't think there's a way that you can stop working. I mean, I don't. Hey, look, it's Christmas. I'm working. And that's because we live in a system where it's musical chairs, and every day they take chairs away. You're like, but they told me to go to college, get a degree, and everything would be fine, and get a job, and have retirement. Poof, that doesn't exist anymore. Now I know why everyone in Texas doesn't like Californians. Think about this. You have a house. Perfect. Congratulations. White picket fence. The kids are running around. They're mowing your lawn for you. Everything is hunky-dory. Unless that's some weird racial slur that I was unaware of, but you're paying a thousand. Let's just say you're paying a thousand. You pay off. You listen to Dave Ramsey, and he says, pay off your dumpster, okay, that you live in, because this is fine. Everything will be fine. So you pay it off, but you have to pay, well, it's just willy-nilly, $1,000 a month for property tax. Okay. Then everyone from California floods over into your state, and now you're paying $2,000 a month in property tax because your house that was valued at $500,000 is now worth $1 million. Congratulations. But now you live in the same house with the same bad kids that want the same amount of money every single year for Christmas. And they're like, but Dad, you look how much money, your house is worth $1 million. You're like, it doesn't feel like it. But my point is, you are in a system that you're busted. There's nothing you could do. Well, except for, like Warren Buffett says, money just always has to be coming in. And I would suggest that whatever you're working with, your hands, that you actually enjoy it. That's what I used to teach in high school. I'm like, don't listen to anything anyone says. Figure out what you like doing and do that. And my students would be like, no, Bravo. My mom and dad said you're stupid. They said I need to go to Harvard and get into $500,000 in student loan debt and become a doctor. So that way I have to give at least 60% of all the money that I make back to the government. Or like me becoming a teacher, master's degree, going for a doctorate, teaching college. This is a great idea. And then I'm like, why am I always broke? They're not telling me the truth. Someone lied to me. So please, whatever you do this year, January 1st, you are going to sell plastic things and learn how to expense plastic things. I mean, you will still have to pay your fair share. Just talk to Elon. What'd he pay? 20 quadrillion this year? But I will tell you, if he was an employee, it would be a whole lot less. Also, please, please, please learn how to trade these things like Elon does. That's where people make their money from. Like, here's Bitcoin. I do a lot of TA on that. I'll do that at the end. See these little bands that are turning? Like those bands that flipped here and it went on a 50% run. Like the bands that flipped here and gave you a 50% run. Do you see possibly another flip? This would be called a swing trade approaching, and your MACD, reverse. There it is. RSI, it's okay, you're above the 50. And Merry Christmas, today is the last few hours that you can take advantage of the $200 course on how to do this. Not the wedgy things like that. But it's my swing trade, very basic. It's just your foot in the door. Okay, this is how I can start growing well. And also, I have some explosive moves. You have a bullish engulfing candle on the week. That's towards the end, because people are like, put Bitcoin at the end. Tell me more about stacking gold. But also gold, silver, it's a way for you to preserve wealth. Stocks, it's a way for you to maybe help you grow a little bit. But you can't hodl, because that over time doesn't work. Because there's things called bull markets and bear markets. You just don't, what's a bear? I've never even heard of that. But using my trading strategies, I was going to say technologies, it's not whatever. You're risk adverse. You're like, oop, you come in, you get out. You come in, you get out. You're always careful. You don't want to lose all your money. And looking at this story, very typical. This guy's 69, truck driver, 30 years, long hours, goes back to school, retirement, Social Security, 59, had a plan. But then his wife bought a house. Dump, dump, dum. And now the pickle, right? It's always when we lived in an apartment, we were doing fine. We could easily afford it, but every year the rent would go up. But then you just found out you have a mortgage and there's a thing called property taxes, which is a lot more than rent. So basically, there is no way out of this matrix, whether you take the red pill or blue pill. We're all effed. But my solution is always going to be the same. Start a business. I'm sorry. I mean, yeah, oh, it's hard to start a business. It's expensive. The failure rate's 9 out of 10. You know, blah, blah, blah. Well, so is living paycheck to paycheck 9 out of 10. It's not doable. I mean, figure out something that someone will pay you for. Do that. Electrician, plumber, whatever. I don't care. I try to tell that to my high school. They're like, that sounds terrible. That doesn't even rhyme with the word TikTok. And you have to use your hands? I mean, like my daughter, Kayla, she's a TikToker, does very well, but she works like me every single day. You don't ever stop working. But what you can do is mitigate damages by figuring out what you like to do. Hire someone. Now you can kind of take a break. Well, until they steal all your money and then you gotta, you know, take them to court and they go to jail. Then you find out they're sleeping with your wife. But I mean, it's complicated. I get it. And there's a reason for why I put my courses in order. When it was like, start a business on Amazon selling plastic things like this. There, run, Johnny Bravo. And then learn how to swing trade. Okay, you're getting it. I mean, maybe one of your businesses, oh, by the way, $497, I think, for all of those three that I... today only, but you do the business, you do the swing trade, and then you go more into the technical where you can play it on the 1 hour or the 4 hour. You're like, ooh, look, it's going to break. And then it does. But hopefully in all this, you're at least enjoying it. You're not, you know, oh, I got to get up. You know, the alarm clock goes off. And that's even when I started this channel. It was like, I got to fix this. So I even started this channel on businesses, right? Teaching my high school kids, my college kids, like start businesses, trade equities, and this is how the progression is. And please, whatever you do, don't say someday. Okay, 2023. You know, like you didn't take advantage of it in 2020 when I was jumping up and down. 2021, 2022. This little thing that's going to happen. Now there is a downside risk. So, you know, you have to score it or chart it carefully, right? You got to mitigate your losses. You can't, you're like, oh, I could have that much gain, but that much loss. You got to go into it with a plan. And I also understand plans too. Coming from Mike Tyson, everyone has a plan until they punch you in the face. And this just in looks like everyone spent all of their money in their accounts. What a great little chart. Look at that. Going, we actually, we're at 6.9. I can remember 69. This goes back, what's it, 6.5. I mean, we have to go pretty far back. This is, and I think maybe the government's like, I have a great solution for this. Let's just repeat 2020 again. And then the rich get more yachts and the have-nots just barely squeak by. And also from the other monetary base, look at that. Although they're like, we're starting to cool here a little bit. Can we fix that? My yacht needs some more go-go juice.
So this is like a perfect correlation. The rich get richer and the poor get poorer.
And also a little bit about money that you might not know about and occasionally like to explain on this channel. Here's actually commercial and industrial loans. We had a little slight uptick. Huh, I wonder why. And then a recession. We had a big uptick. How is that? Or why is it when we're in a recession, money goes up? This is so confusing. Well, that's because money is debt. Money is loans. You go buy a house, they now have for $1 million. Poof, the bank now has $1 million. Cash, look at all that. Look at their balance sheets. You want to, you know, PPP, whatever, anything that's loan, a car loan, anything that is like new created cash. I mean, trust me, I know it makes no sense. Let's take me, military veteran. I take a VA loan. I say, I want that 100 million. Yeah, they're going to give me 100. Just walk with me on this one. I want that house for $100 million. I'm going to use my VA loan. I'm going to come in with zero down. They say, sure, okay. Your monthly payment is $100,000 a month. Poof, they just created $100 million. Or if it's $1 million house. Yeah, I want that house. Okay, $1 million. Poof, $1 million. There it is. Right on the banking system. And then what's even crazier than that, the stuff, I have no, my wife has my wallet. She's going to take out some cash. She doesn't, she keeps it all. But if I were to take out that said cash and run down to my bank account or run down to someone's my bank and put it in there, they're like, oh, that's a liability. Got to put that into the repo market. So hopefully I've confused you enough. I just want you to understand it is a system designed to keep you on a hamster wheel. So just know that I'm trying to help you maybe put other people on the hamster wheel so you don't have to do it. And also looking at the charts this Christmas of everyone being broke, cash rules everything. No, I hate cash. Cash is trash. Around Christmas. Here, you guys want to know what's going on money? You want to know who wants to receive money? 40% money. The other one, vouchers or more money. So you're looking at 40, 50, 60, 75% of you are like, just, I can't survive. Give me money. Or then give me something like a gift card that I can then buy that survival item for myself so I can survive. And actually, for me, it's right here, this one. So drinks. I don't know if that's what they're talking about, just to numb the pain. You know, you got those in-laws, which should probably be classified as outlaws. Just not, you know, how do I numb this? Which is probably the first or second step in realizing that maybe I do have a problem and I should probably take a gift card to like AA. And also just to show you guys that we are all broke, look, you're like, they don't look broke. Oh, no. There's numbers that will show you. Here we go. And they're going to say, oh, it's this, right? It's always, it's that thing over there. Starts to show slow U.S. economy. U.S. economy is slowing. Oh, can't wait for these GDP numbers. 2022. Make it 2020 again. U.S. economy as consumer spending flags. Fewer people are dining in restaurants. A rising case number? I don't think so. Leading many businesses to close for a short period. Maybe we'll just shut them all down again. I mean, it looks like that's what China's doing again. That's going to be great for 2022. I mean, can people figure out? This is like insanity. Did it work the first time? Nope. I mean, it did for the rich. So, you know what? It worked. Let's do it again. I mean, how much did the people really recognize that inflation thing? And maybe crash the holidays? Shrinking menus and spoiling traditions? And why don't we just throw another problem into the blender? America, not just, well, America, China, all countries is not good. If you look at the demographics and our geopopulation, and did I use that word in the right context? I'm sorry if I did not. Like stuff's in your head, you're like, just try it. See if it sounds okay. We're shrinking. We're like, I don't want to have kids. I don't think it's a good idea. This isn't looking too good. And with inflation and hyperinflation and the way the system is all set up, and Americans would be more happy with more people, believe it or not. And how are we going to pay for all these boomers? Oh, they collected assets. They should be okay. But what about the rest of y'all, which I can't say y'all, you guys. But you all are you guys. We got to take care of the boomers. Where's that going to come from? Oop. Got some deep pockets, also known as get a job, raise your taxes, wink, wink. And all these boomers that are retiring, they're like, wait, I paid into it. Come on. Well, here's the problem, boomer. You paid into it, but you spent it. Oh, like you didn't know? And so then there we are again, having to go back to work. Golly gee, this is great. Maybe I should have listened to Bravo 30 years ago, 50 years ago, when he said, you know what? I should have started a business. I should have taken this course when it was on sale. Hire people. That would have been a great idea. Maybe even learn how to trade equities. I mean, the least I could, maybe I should subscribe to this guy. Maybe there's something in his noggin. All right, so here we are. We are doing the Bitcoin. For those of you who are like, that's it, bye. I don't need it. Guys, this is going to be a very, very big one. And I honestly tell that to my wife every night. She's like, you're clearly going to lie to me again. But what I want to do is I want to drop my time frame to weekly. This is going to be, I even put little, see, I put these things on my charts just to remind me, hey, talk about it. See this right here? This is called a bullish engulfing candle. It needs to close above, see that 50K? We're at almost 51K, and we have 1 day and 3 hours left. If we do that, it will probably do what it did over there. Let's hope so, because then it'll take out my little Fibonacci thing right there. And then we're like, oh, okay, that's not a head and shoulders pattern. Huh. Ho-ho. Where are we going, Mickey? Look at this. Look at this bullish engulfing. From bottom, from trough to peak, what are we at? 69? Did we pull a 69 on that one? And here, let me move it a little bit for you. Let's do another bullish engulfing candle. Man, I wish I would have learned about this when I was younger. We're going to go from the bottom of that wick all the way to the top. We are at 80%. Yes. But then my good news, I always have to balance it with bad news. I know. See this candle? That's red. You don't want that one red. That's two candles on the monthly in a row. Red. So we need to get up here. We need to get right at 57,000. And it looks like you have 6 days and 3 hours to make it to 57,000. Okay, so I balance this with good news, bad news. Or you can do a shorter time frame. Like when these flip, man, or you can be a little ahead of the curve. Okay, on these on the ribbons. When these ribbons flip, let me measure this for you. Right here to there. There's their 50%, probably 50%. Let's come down here, move this thing, any flippy flippy. Oh, that was a huge, whew.
That's a really big one, babe. I gotta get out my big ruler for that one.
This was a flip at 519%. I mean, you still do have some time on these plays, but when they take, this is gonna be fun. Is it just me? This is better than like a football game. Look at this. This was that measured on that head and shoulders. If that plays out, we hit Fibonacci, we come down. We drop all the way down to, the $20,000 range. It's like, are we going Lambo money or are we going broke? I just feel like this is Super Bowl. This is like the end of the four-year cycle. Is Bitcoin going to do what Bitcoin usually does? Which it usually surprises everyone, no matter what. You're like, wow, went down to 3,700. Didn't see that coming. Also, just to let you guys know, there's roughly 19 million that's in circulation right now. Guess how many are actually in circuit? How many are on the exchanges? Like, none of them are. One out of the 19. There's none out there. And all these whales keep trying to manipulate and collect it. There's only going to be 21. We're currently at 19. Out of those 19 that are in circulation, one of them is on the exchanges.
Well, now that you say that, Bravo, maybe I should learn about this stuff. Hey, where could I learn about it from?
I have no idea, man. But you got a few hours left to grab it, and I will see you tomorrow, because I film every single day, even though I don't have to, on Christmas, because I love what I do. So is it really a job? Probably not.